Students, we are studying about the skeletal muscles. In the last class, I told you about the skeletal muscles. We will be studying a little bit of detail of the skeletal muscles today. Before going on with the class, let us see a little bit of what we studied last time. We didn't study much last time. However, let us just have a revision, a brief overview, and then we can go to the detail. Each muscle, the structure of the skeletal muscle, each muscle is made up of bundles of muscle fibers. Bundles of muscle fibers. Muscle fibers are known as the muscle cells. Now, this is the muscle bundle. And this is the extension of the muscle, which is called the tendon, and it is joining to the bone. Inside the muscle bundle is enclosed by a tough new tissue, which is known as epimysium. Inside the muscle bundle, we have smaller bundles, which are known as fascicles. These fascicles, they contain even smaller thread-like structures which are parallelly arranged, which is known as a muscle fiber. The muscle fiber is also called the muscle cell. Inside this muscle fiber, I told you, we have the sarcoplasm, and it is enclosed externally by the sarcolemma. And this, it is extended into the sarcolemma, is extended into the sarcoplasm, and it forms T-type structures, which are called the T-tubules. Anyway, this was the last structure, the last lecture. Skeletal muscle cells are cells. They have oval nuclei. The diameter is 10 to 100 micrometers. Sarcoplasm contains stored glycogen and myoglobin. Glycogen as a source of energy. Myoglobin as an energy or as oxygen storage. As for oxygen storage, it is because of this myoglobin that skeletal muscles appear red in color. It is because of the presence of myoglobin. And this is a storage pigment. Hemoglobin is a transfer pigment. It carries oxygen from one part of the body to another. Myoglobin is stored inside the muscles. It does not come into the blood. It is a storage pigment. It has a very high affinity for oxygen. Under high magnification, when we observe the muscle fiber, we see that it contains smaller thread-like structures, which are called the myofibrils. Even inside the muscle cell, we have myofibrils, which are mainly protein in nature. These myofibrils are 1 to 2 micrometer in diameter. And these myofibrils, they run parallel along the whole length of the muscle. They do not intertwine with each other. The fibrils, this whole muscle cell is enclosed in the sarcolemma. Now, this is something new, the sarcomere. The sarcomere is something new that we have to study in detail right now. I will tell you the detail of the sarcomere at present. The sarcomere is a contractile unit of the myofibril. The dark A band, which is anisotropic, means that it does not disperse of light. It absorbs the light more and then it appears darker. It is known as A band. This dark A band is made up of myosin. And then the light band, which is I band, and it absorbs less light and kind of disperses more light out. And that is known as isotropic band, right? It is known as the isotropic band. Now keep one thing in mind. Inside the dark band, we have a specific zone, known as the H zone, which is a little bit different in appearance as compared to the general dark band. And then in the light band, which is known as the I band, we have a dark zone in the center. I will tell you the detail of these things, but first of all, let us go over a brief overview of the introduction to the muscle cells. Each muscle fiber is long, cylindrical, unbranched cell with a diameter of 10 to 100 micrometers. It is covered by a sarcolemma and it contains a semi-fluid matrix of sarcoplasm with many peripheral nuclei. I told you that they are multinucleated cells. Skeletal muscles are multinucleated cells. They have many nuclei. It has many nuclei, it has many mitochondria. I told you that the mitochondria in the muscle cells are called the sarcosomes. Then it has sarcoplasmic reticulum. This is the endoplasmic reticulum that is present in the muscle cells. It is the endoplasmic reticulum, which is known as the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Then it has myoglobin. I just told you the function of myoglobin, oxygen storage, and it has glycogen, energy source. Now, this is the sarcoplasm. which is present inside the sarcolemma, which is present inside the sarcolemma. In beneath the sarcolemma, we have these protein threads extending throughout. These protein threads, you can see they have a regular presence of dark and light bands. The dark band is said to be the A band and the light band is said to be the I band. Now, this is the A band. This is the A band and this is a lighter region in the A band, which is known as the H zone, which we just studied. This is the H zone. The lighter region in the A band, this is the H zone. We will study why this is a little bit lighter as compared to the connecting areas, right? So, myofibrils, each muscle fiber, a large number of contractile subunits called the myofibrils, 1 to 2 micrometers in diameter. They are present along the entire length of the muscle cell. This is the sarcomere. The sarcomere is actually the basic contractile unit. Now I am going to tell you what is present inside the myofibril and what is the sarcomere. This is the muscle cell. And this muscle cell, it is made up of alternate lighter and darker regions. It's made up of alternate lighter and darker regions. This light region is called the I band and this dark region is called the H band. This I band is made up of a protein which is called actin. And it is known as the thin band. Is known as a thin band. And this darker band is made up of a protein which is called myosin. And it is known as the thick band. Now, this is the difference. This is a region in the A band, in the dark band, which is a little bit lighter in color. This is known as the H zone. This is the H zone, a little bit lighter as compared to the surrounding ones. And in the center of the H zone, it is bisected by a line, which is called the M line. It is called the M line. Now, this is the I band. This is the A band. In the center of the A band is the H zone. And in the center of the H zone is present the M line. Now, when we come to the I band, the I band is bisected in the center by a line which is called the Z line. I am going to tell you what sarcomere is, the basic contractile unit. The sarcomere is actually the distance between one Z line and the other Z line. Now, this is the sarcomere from this Z line to this Z line. This is the basic contractile unit of a cell. We will be studying the detail of this contractile unit in the next lecture. But at present, just remember that the sarcomere is actually the zone of the muscle fibril, which is ranging from one Z zone to from one Z line to the next Z line. And the Z line is present inside the I band. I will go to the board and write it on the board for you people also so that it can be easy for you to understand. These are arranged in small contractile units or sarcomeres with light and dark bands alternating with each other. The ulcer structure of the myofibril, we will do it in the next class. Let me go to the board and let me explain what we have studied today so that it can become easy for you people to remember. Now, first of all, we discussed the structure already. We have already discussed the simple structure. Today, we have studied a little bit of detail of the muscle fiber. The muscle fiber is actually known as the muscle cell. It's known as the muscle cell. And this muscle cell, it has a covering, which is called the sarcolemma. Is called the sarcolemma. Inside the sarcolemma, we have a cytoplasm, which is known as the sarcoplasm. It is called the sarcoplasm. Inside the sarcoplasm, we have special types of protein fibers, which are known as the myofibrils. They are known as the myofibrils. When we observe these myofibrils in detail, we see that they are made up of different types of proteins. And those different types of proteins are known as the myofilaments. When we observe the myofilaments, we see that we have two types of myofilaments. We have the actin filament, and then we have the myosin filament. The actin filament and the myosin filament. The muscle cell, when the muscle fiber is said to have, is seen to have a dark and a light region. It is seen to have a dark and a light region. A dark and a light region. Dark and the light region is because of the distribution of these myofilaments. It is because of the distribution of the myofilaments, the actin and the myosin. In the light region, we have actin, and in the dark region, we have myosin. Right? Now, this myosin, let me draw it on the board for you people. In the next class, we will study this detailed structure. Now, this, let us say that this is the dark band, which is made up of myosin. This is the dark band, which is made up of myosin. This is the myosin. Right? This is the myosin. And this is the light band. Let me draw the light band with another line. Okay. This is the light band. This is just to explain. This is the light band. Right? This is the light band. Now, this light band is seen to light band. This is the dark band and this is the light band. This dark band is made up of myosin. This light band is made up of actin. This region is a little bit darker because the actin is overlapping the myosin and it appears to be a little bit darker. This area where the actin is not overlapping the myosin, this is known as the H zone. This is the H zone. And this H zone is bisected in the center by a line, which is called the M line. M line and the H zone are present in the dark filament, in the dark region, in the dark band. Now, this is the light band. This is the I band. This is the A band. This is the I band. This I band in the center, it is bisected by another line, which is known as the Z line, the line of Zwishin. This is the Z line, the line of Zwishin, right? This is the Z line, which is known as the line of Zwishin. The distance between one line of Zwishin, this one, and the other line of Zwishin, this, is known as the sarcomere. It is known as the sarcomere, which is the basic contractility. Which is the sarcomere? This is the sarcomere. Distance between one Z line and the other Z line is known as a sarcomere, and this is a basic contractile unit. The Z line lies in the light band. This is the M line, which is bisecting the H zone. This is the H zone. This is the H zone. You can see the heel zone. It is that area where the actin is not overlapping the myosin. This is the actin. This is the actin. This is the myosin. This is the extent of the area where the actin is overlapping the myosin. And this is the area where it is not present. This area is called the H zone. The distance between one, in the center of the H zone is present the M line. We have the M line over here also, right? Now, in the light band, in the I band, we have a line which is bisecting the I band, and this is known as the Z line. The distance between one Z line and another Z line is called the sarcomere, and the Z line is called the line of Zwishin. It's called the line of Zwishin. This is all for the lecture today. We will continue with the ultrastructure tomorrow. See you people next time. Stay updated with the lectures and do to ask me any questions. Drop your questions in the comment section. Okay, Vita. Allah Hafiz. Take care.